Hello, good day everyone. This is Maryam Bichi. I'm a digital marketer with specialization in social media marketing, content marketing, and e-commerce. So also I'm an entrepreneur. I run so many businesses, but to be specific, I'm the founder of EasyMart Online Market. And then I am also the founder and creative director of Dazzler Concept. I'm a freelancer. I also consult and coach small business owners on how they can run and manage their social media pages, or in general, how they can run their businesses online. And also I work with BAS Multiservices, a banking agency and a tech company in Kano. It's really nice to be here, and a wow, big thank you to Last Innovation Hub that invited me here. To Abakar and his team, well done, and thanks for having me here. So ladies, let's get into work. I am going to talk about digital marketing and financial literacy. So I'll take you through my slides so that we can see a little bit of what I have put together for us in order to understand digital marketing. I also have some links that I am going to drop for us so that we can have we can go and check some sites to learn about digital marketing, and also some free studying sites where we can earn some certificates in digital marketing. Let's dive in. Thank you. Simply, what's digital marketing? Digital marketing, it's synonymously called online marketing. It's the marketing that we use modern digital devices like our computers and mobile phones in advertising, promoting, and also selling of our digital products and services. We can reach more people, more and more people, because most people are on the go with their digital devices, more especially the mobile phone. That is why digital marketing is applied in order to reach more and more people. Simply, so in this slide, we are going to discuss the digital marketing strategy and the DIX formula, which is how you can define your foundation, how you set your goals, how you set your strategy, how you can specify your action plan, and how you can communicate your plan. So in this slide, we also discuss the types and tactics of digital marketing. Let's look at the benefits of setting digital marketing strategy. If you don't have strategy in your online marketing, you are going to waste your time, because using digital platforms, it's makes you to be multitasking, switching from one platform to another, and multitasking kills productivity. So this multitasking is going to make you to waste your time, you confuse yourself, your priorities get confused, your decisions they take longer to make, time is wasted. It's easy for team members to lose focus because they don't have strategy. So this slide is going to explain to us the digital marketing strategy, how we can set our strategies. So before you start any digital marketing campaign, I want you to know these three things. Number one, list projects you are currently working on. Identify where you are getting overwhelmed. And then identify where you think your team members are wasting time. So the reason why I said these three things are very important is, even if you are doing any kind of digital marketing campaign or you are yet to start, this is where you will have to understand first before start. Now let's look at the modern marketing strategy. Use of digital tools, platform and network for marketing, which entails market analysis, survey, advertisements, etc. A simple definition of marketing is that it is the creation and satisfaction of demand for your product or services. If it goes well, this demand should translate into sales and ultimately revenue, right? So, like our normal traditional and physical form of marketing strategies and
they are formed, goals, objectives, visions, and missions need to be set in order for you to get effective results in any kind of business or organization. So in brief, it is very important to set objectives or goals which are SMART. SMART means specific, measurable, attainable, and realistic. They should also be time-bound. So in any digital marketing, you have to set a SMART objective. For example, in setting an objective, you can say to get 500,000 followers between December to January 2021. Let's look at different tactics of digital marketing and their evaluation. We have about 8 types of digital marketing, which are called digital marketing tactics. We have the SEO, which is for customer retention or acquisition. We have the search engine marketing or pay-per-click, which is for sales, customer retention, and acquisition also. We have the online advertisement, that's the display ads, email marketing, social media ads, which is for branding and also acquisition as well. We also have the social media marketing, which is the branding, value creation, and participation of followers. We also have the video marketing, that's video content, which is also for branding, customer retention, and value creation. We have the email marketing, which is mainly for customer retention and value creation. We also have the e-commerce marketing, which is the online selling. It's also for customer acquisition and retention. Then the affiliate marketing, which is for sales, branding, and it's widely used to promote e-commerce websites. Now let's look at the next formula. As I said and explained different tactics of digital marketing, you have to understand them and know how to apply them by using this DIX formula. D is the defined stage in the DIX formula. Here, it's where you identify your number one core values, your product and services, your ideal customer, and your unique value proposition. What is your core value? Your core value, they reflect your business purpose, visions, culture of your organization. Product and services, they are the essentials of any business. They determine its profitability. That is, what do you sell? What are you selling? Then, an ideal customer. In any kind of digital marketing or any kind of marketing, you have to know which customers you consider the most valuable. Who are they? Who are your target segments? Who are you selling? What is, like, you need to have an outline ideal customer. You can even have a customer avatar. Then your unique value. One single phrase or summary which explains your unique value proposition and your values, your benefits, and any other offer. It's not just a slogan or statement, yeah? Let's look at this stage. You see, this is your unique value proposition, which explains how your product or services solve problem, tells customers what specific benefit they can expect from your product or services, and also describe what sets you apart from your competitors. This is your unique value proposition. Now, the identify stage, that is the eye of the D. At your identify stage, you should be able to identify and outline your purpose of marketing. Your purpose can be your sales, lead generation, brand awareness, what you seem to get. Just have a purpose, which, as we already explained earlier, as your objectives, your main objective, and your objectives should be SMART. Let's see, for example, you said increase sales through e-commerce platform by 10% within the next 6 months. You see, this is a SMART objective, which includes your specific, your attainable, your reliability, your time bound, and realistic. And the tactics you are going to use, for example, is search engine and Facebook brand page. So here you've also set your KPIs, which are your key performance indicators. So this is an example of the identifying stage. So if you are finished with the identifying stage, now we are going to the selecting your marketing strategies. Now that we have clearly identified our marketing goals, now let's go to the selection. The purpose of this marketing strategy is to address a business brand challenge or objective that has been revealed. So How can you select your marketing strategy? Firstly, you have to answer these 5 questions. Number 1, what is your cost? 2, what is the easiest strategy you can implement right now? 3, what has worked best in the past? Is there anything you already know or you need to do more to achieve success? What is the most wanted on the list of strategies? If what you are doing now is successful, what next? So in selecting your marketing strategies, you have to reach out to others in your market who have similar audience to you. Number 2, you have to attend networking events and meet up to make contacts. You have to approach blogs, websites, and accounts that offer the same services like yours, and then interact, thus create social media profiles which you can spend time in interacting, and then you create that to others in your market who have similar audience and customers. These are stages you have to look at when selecting which type of strategy you are going to implement in your digital marketing strategy. If you already have a customer base or you have an active social media account, you have to set up and schedule how you will be posting, add time sensitive to new posts, run advertisement, have an email marketing, have an email bucket list that you will be sending emails to your customers. And then if you already have an email list, then you should be running engagement campaign in order to retain your customers. Finally, find ways to better optimize the results, figure out ways to diversify, and devise ways of reporting your progress always. Then the next step is specify your action plan on the DIX formula. This is where 50% of the work is done when running your digital marketing campaign. When you are specifying your action plan, you have to create a list of metrics related to your marketing goal and strategy which you've picked before. Prioritize your list. Specify important and relevant metrics. Look for people, that is staffs, employees, and freelancers that you can work with. Then specify your funds. Expenses you will face like ads, subscriptions, and then look for tools which are digital devices and training. There are a few new skills you should learn before embarking on this journey of digital marketing. If you also need someone to advertise for, you should also specify that in your plan. Then the communicating stage, which is communicate effectively to your team members on your digital marketing team or business or organization. This is the last team that make up the DIX formula. This involves getting anyone on the same page. They need to be on point with the goals and objectives you have set. Create guidelines for team. If there is things that they don't understand, make them understand. And your guidelines should include the main goals and visions you've set, your marketing strategy in details, all the steps involved, all resources needed, and everything that you need in running your digital marketing campaign. How progress will be marked, key responsibilities of each members, that's all. So this is the end of the digital marketing strategy. I hope you will be able to set objectives and your goals for your businesses when starting any digital marketing. Choose tactics to achieve them, select a strategy to carry them out, and be able to specify action and tracking progress. Thank you. Don't forget, if you have any problem, you can reach me out on my social media handles at @MariamBichi_. My DMs are open always and forever.
I hope you enjoyed watching this light. Don't forget to reach me out whenever and ever you are ready at my social media pages at @MariamBichi_. And I really appreciate it. My DMs are very open. If you have any problem or any question that you want to ask me about digital marketing, more especially social media marketing or content marketing. I'll be there to support you. Thank you, Last Innovation Hub, and everyone, have a nice day.